Hey y'all, let's move the mirror. It's been a minute. As you can see, I got a new setting done on my camera, so I'm giving more of a wide look. So I hope you guys noticed it, and I hope it's better. I don't freaking know, but anyways, it's been a while. So I recorded me doing this face. I'm going to a concert today with my husband. I'm going to see Anthony Hamilton and I think the Isley Brothers. So yeah, this is the face I created using some new product. So continue to watch so I can show you how I tell you and show you how these products are used. And again, don't forget to like, comment, and subscribe to the channel and let me know what you guys think. But yeah, bye.
Blowing no smoke. I mean, I've been sober, but you should have known it. I wasn't going.
Hey y'all, I know it's been a freaking minute. I've been slacking, but we about to get into this face. We are going to a concert. My birthday is in 3 days. I got concert tickets to see Anthony Hamilton and Isley Brothers. They were supposed to come this summer, but the freaking concert got canceled and it got pushed back to this weekend. And of course it worked out for me because it's my birthday weekend, so me and my husband is going to go. So first we are going to brush these brows in place. So we're going to use a Benefit brown pencil that is shaped like this oblong, and I use this solely just to draw my line underneath my brows. I do the same thing for my brows every time. Did y'all catch that Ulta sale? Because I got me a new Benefit brown pencil, Benefit eyebrow pencil, blah, 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 blah. A new pencil. 50% off, baby. $13 instead of $26. Ha! Can't beat that. So again, I just draw a simple line. I don't know if y'all can see. Can y'all tell that my setup is a little different? Does it look like I got a new camera? Does it? Because I didn't. I just played with some settings. And the view is a little bit different and I like it better. So it took me a minute to freaking figure it out. Thank goodness for YouTube. Okay. So yeah, simple. Draw a line up, draw a line at the bottom. Okay, so now that we got both brows lined at the bottom and at the top, now I'm going to use my skinny pencil and I'm just going to fill it in. I feel like I need to get a little bit closer. Let me get, and don't mind the face breakout because it's there and I don't know what's going on. I tell my kids it's their stress they bring to me that causes my face to break out. Okay, look at this. Anyways, so we're gonna do hair like strokes in the front just like this, and it don't have to be precise because we're gonna use our concealer and we're gonna clean up the brows. So I just do like little hair like strokes throughout the brow. I don't make them too dark. I just like to make sure, you know, there's really no big spaces in the brow. So I know they're looking big right now, but don't worry, we are going to conceal them to give a better shape. I'm going to use my NYX brow glue and I just like two brushes through my brow. It keeps them in place. I really like this stuff because, I mean, it's not expensive and it works. The other one I do like is the brow freeze gel from Anastasia. That one works really good. I just refuse to buy any more makeup product because I have so freaking much. So I'm using up what I have, and when I run low, that's what I'll be buying next. So again, we're just gonna run that through the brow. So now that the NYX glue is on my eyebrows, we're gonna conceal. I use a Kevin Aucoin and this is an XX13. Well, what the heck. And I use my Morphe brush, hit this one that almost fell apart on me, M342. It's just a brush that go across. I like using this style of a brush versus the curved one. I don't know, I feel like I have more control with this one. So I'm just going to line underneath the brows. That's it. So both the brows are aligned at the bottom. Now sometimes I do the top part of my tail just so I can give a sharp look. I really like using a foundation to do it because it matches more and it doesn't give you that, you know, bright at the top of it. But at this point, just to be honest, I'm being lazy and I don't feel like getting that out right now. So I'm gonna take a fluffy brush like this and I'm just going to brush it out. But yeah, so I changed the settings on my camera, so I have more of like a wide angle in my camera or my view, and I think it looks a lot better. Again, you guys are zoomed in right now, so it kind of looks like how it was before. But yeah, baby, I was YouTubing a couple weeks ago and I'm like, I gotta get my camera, because I know this camera can do what I want it to do. I just gotta freaking do some work, okay? So we're gonna use our Aerospun, the same products for real. And I do have some new products, y'all, we're gonna use today. I'm excited. I used them already, but we're gonna use them again today. So again, we're setting the brows and the eyelid just so it doesn't become patchy when we're using eyeshadow and our brows are not shiny. Okay, so we are going to use our Morphe palette. And I'm wearing like this jean skirt outfit, and it's like a grayish blackish color. So I'm gonna say it's a faded black jean skirt outfit. So I think I'm gonna do a gray eye. I haven't done that in a while. So I'm gonna use this palette and I'm gonna use this gray on my Anastasia palette here. And I'm gonna use this here, this shade here, for my transition shade. So I'm gonna just see what this looks like. I don't even know if you'd be able to see it on the camera. But it's like I don't even know what kind of color to call it. It's gray, brown mix. So we're just gonna use that as a transition shade. And we're not gonna do too much because I have this other dark gray that I'm gonna put right below it. So this is what we're calling our transition shade. We are just gonna transition this into our gray shades. Okay, so now we're gonna use this palette. You see I like that transition? Gray color. Okay, so now I'm going to use this gray color here. And then I'm going to just do that right below it. And let's see what that looks like. And I'm just using a big fluffy brush like that. Yeah, so Wednesday is my birthday. This year, I don't know. Usually I'm trying to always do something big for my birthday. But this year I just wasn't feeling it. And a couple of my friends was like, so what are we doing for your birthday? And I'm just like, yeah, I'm just not in the mood this year. So you know, now they're like, is everything okay? I don't know. I don't think it's just because of it's not a big milestone. It's like not 40, not 30, 35. It's just, I don't know. So I just wasn't really feeling it this year. Okay, so now we're gonna use a Makeup by Mario palette, and we're gonna use this black one here. And we are just going to pounce that right in our corner. This is the one we do like that backwards V. I don't know. But we're just going to, and then we're going to kind of pull it out this way to go over that dark gray that we have. And we're just going to keep right here in the back, pounce it, and then just bring it over. Alright, so now that we have our black mixed in with our grays, don't worry, it's gonna come together. I know it's looking crazy, but we're gonna use this Anastasia, back to the Anastasia palette, and we're gonna use this gray, and I'm gonna just use my finger. Yeah, so it looks like this. Ooh, and I'm gonna use my finger. Oh, this is so pretty, and I don't even think the camera is doing justice. And then I'm going to really shape it with a brush. Brush like this, just to kind of blend it in. This metallic. I'm going to have to put a little bit on my brush. I do not like to do cut creases. It's just too precise. And don't nobody got time for that. So we're just gonna put, I don't know if y'all can even see it, but it's super pretty. Okay, so we are finished with the eyes. I did a little eyeliner, very little small eyeliner, just to kind of bring it together, but that's it. So now, so we can kind of like clean this up, I'm gonna just take a Neutrogena eye wipe or makeup wipe remover, and we are just gonna use my finger and just do one of those moments. I'm gonna just use my wipe, and I'm gonna wipe off any fallout, just a little bit. Okay, so now we're gonna use our eye cream, our Bobbi Brown eye cream, and I'm gonna put it underneath the eyes, because baby, we don't want no creases. I need to get another one. I was hoping also was gonna have the Bobbi Brown eye cream on sale for 50% off too, and they didn't. This one that I have now is the one I got last year on there, 50% off. So, and this lasts me a whole year, and I put makeup on quite often. And look, okay, so one of the new things that I picked up this week was this one size oil sucker. I'm gonna shake it up. It says to shake it up, apply it to the face, allow it to dry for 3 minutes. So you got to give yourself time for this one. Actually, before we do that, I'm lying. Let's put some moisturizer on the face. I'm gonna use my e.l.f. Holy Hydration, because my face is feeling a tad bit dry. So now let's use this one size. So women be get this because I wear makeup, and this here don't use that much, but as you see, I'm kind of putting a lot on, which I didn't really mean to. Okay, let me back up a little bit. Okay, so it says this to pat it in the places that you're gonna get oily. And well, the reason why I was saying I got this is because I wear makeup at work, and I do 10-hour shifts. So you think I usually have my makeup on for about 12 hours. Excuse me. And my face eventually starts to get really oily over time, just kind of like walking the halls or whatever and working. And my face gets really oily right beside my nose, my chin area. So I bought this, and I did notice a difference. A huge difference? Not really, but I did notice a difference. So I'm going to try it out today. I still got to cook dinner and then go to this concert. So we'll see how this plays out. But you saw how much I put on. Once you put this stuff on, let it sit. I mean, you basically really feel your face start getting dry and mattifying. So it just feels like I didn't moisturize my face at all when you apply that one size. Just for you to know. Now we're going to use our Epar grip. I am just not a one primer kind of girl, so we are just going to pat that over the areas that you get oily, and again, it allows your foundation to stick to your face. Okay, so those are the only two primers that we're going to use today, and we'll see how well those two primers work. Again, I said I have to cook dinner, and I'm going to this concert, so I pray to God we don't get oily. So we are going to use for foundation our House Labs, and then this is in shade 460 medium deep warm. This is a warm shade, so it looks a little bit orange on my face, but it oxidizes a little bit and it kind of blends in. So just, I may look crazy in the beginning, but pay no mind. Okay, so we're gonna do one pump here and one pump here, and then I'm gonna just use my Morphe brush that looks like this, and I'm gonna just spread it around. I do say one day I want to do underpainting. I watch a lot of girls do it, and their sole purpose is using less foundation. I don't know. I just feel like they're using a lot of other products instead, but I'm all about trying to make makeup process a little bit faster, and I feel like maybe it may be faster, and that's the only reason why I want to try it. So okay, so I'm going to use my Tarte Shape concealer, and then this is in the shade Deep. I rarely pull this out, so we're going to use it today. And we're just going to apply it to the areas we want to highlight. Goodness, I barely have anything in there. Okay. So the concealer's on, the foundation's on. I had got this Curve case. It is super good. It is definitely worth your money. And this is what the shade looks like. If you don't follow me on TikTok, please do, because I did a video on this. And these are what the shades look like. This is more of a warm shade bronzer. And this is really the next good contour shade for me. And then this is a really deep contour shade for me. This gives me more of a gray shade, which I don't care for. And I'm surprised, and I don't know why it does that. And these are all the blushes, right? So this one is too light. It's like an orange color. And then this is our tangerine shade, pink, and like this really soft pink color shade or whatever. But I am going to bronze, so we're going to use this shade here, okay? while my concealer, and I'm going to just use this brush that looks like this. You see, I literally just put it in one time. You see the pigment? And I'm going to put it right here and right here. And we are just going to blend that out. And I'm going to show you what that dark shade look like, because I'm going to do that on my forehead. But yeah, this is definitely worth your money. I mean, this was only, I got it on sale, I think it was like $24. But if you like to do that TikTok stuff and buy on TikTok, they'd be having really good sales with this, product. So, I mean, you can get really, you can get it cheap. And it's worth it, because you see what all you get. You get a bunch of different shades of bronzers, contour shades, and freaking blushes. And only $25. And I mean, do you see the pigment? Do you see the pigment? Okay. And then I'm gonna go on with this one next. This shade here, so you can see the next shade. And I'm gonna just bring that on my forehead. And you see this color that it gives? And we are just going to blend that in. And remember, push it into your hairline so you don't have no line of demarcation here and looking crazy, okay? You're welcome. So now let's use my Real Technique brush. This brush here, our setting brush. And then, actually, before I do that, let me just use my Morphe setting spray and set the face. Okay, now let's blend out this concealer. I haven't used Tarte concealer in such a long time. I can't remember if I liked it or not, honestly. I don't know. When I first started doing makeup, like, this was like the hottest concealer to freaking buy. You gotta wear Tarte. And I felt like they didn't, I don't know, it went from here, this shade, to I think tan deep or something. I don't know, I just felt like the colors wasn't amazing for me. And this is my first expensive concealer that I ever bought. What was your first expensive concealer or first expensive product you bought? Because I know it took me a while, baby, because I was using LA Pro Girl concealer. I mean, and I still see some girls that I watch on TikTok, they still use her. And I know why, because it works very well. I'm going to use my Makeup by Mario. This is in shade 420 for highlight, and I am just going to bring it down like that. This product, you don't have to have it sit on for a long time, because I'm telling you, it gets thick, and if you let it sit for a long time, that mother sucker is hard to blend out. Okay, while that's sitting, let me actually use my curve case again, and I'm gonna use I'm gonna just use a beauty blender, and I'm gonna use this pink shade here just a little bit and pat it right on top of that bronzer. Do you see how pigmented this is? This will give you blush blindness. Now I'm about to put it away, because if I keep holding it, I'm gonna keep using it. I'm gonna use this dark shade here and just kind of go. Do y'all see how dark this is? Ah, love it. Just a little bit. I just pat it in one time. And I would just pat it in one time, and you see the pigment that you get? I'm telling you, you could use all these freaking shades one time. Let's quickly blend out this Makeup by Mario, because baby, she will stay in place. So I am going to make sure I have no creases. I'm gonna push in everything, and then I like to set with the pressed powder before I set with the loose powder. I just feel like it blends out, or it looks a lot more flawless. If I don't do it, it's because I'm rushing. And not to say it makes a huge difference, but I can tell a little bit. So I'm just gonna use my puffer, this here, and I'm gonna use my Maybelline in shade 230. Do this. Blow it out. And just set. I'm gonna do the same thing to the other side. Next product, my new product I have is the Makeup by Mario Loose Setting Powder. And this is in shade Warm Honey. I know my face looks kind of bright with the lighting situation, but I promise it's not as bright as what we see. But this is the Warm Honey. This is what it looks like. Shoot. We cannot be wasting products. Okay, so this is what... I don't even know if y'all can see it. Y'all can't see it. I'm just making a mess. But this is really peachy. It looks peachy. So we're going to use the same powder puff. Actually, let me see if I can show you on here. There we go. That looks a little bit better. And I'm going to just dust off anything extra. Because you really just want it to be almost like pressed powder on the thing.
Yeah.
Just go over. And this shade, I was trying to find something like the Givenchy in shade number 5. Because, you know, I'm going to just use whatever I have here. I'm going to leave the other side. Givenchy came up with a new loose setting powder. And it's like shimmery. Don't nobody want shimmery underneath the eyes, you know? So I was trying to find this in the same shade as the Prism number 5. And I felt like this was it. It's a bit brighter, a little bit, but not much. And we're just going to push this product in the skin. I used this at work on Friday. And again, I wore makeup for like 12 hours. And it did really good. So, I think I have a new favorite. Probably not as better as the one size. Because the one size smacks, okay? And I'm just pushing in the product so it like mushes in well with my skin. But you see how bright it was at first? You probably like, bitch, it's still bright. But no, for real, it's a lot more subtle. And literally you just push it into your skin and it like melts inside your skin. Alright, so we're gonna use our Charlotte Tilbury in shade Deep and we're gonna bronze the face. And I'm gonna use my Patrick Ta dupe. I got this machine. I love this for my bronzer. This probably cost me like $4. Because I was not about to spend that much money on that brush. Not to say I haven't. And I have. And I think that's why I don't spend that much on a brush. Because I hate that brush. That brush was like $30. It was a Morphe brush. Was it Morphe? Yeah, it was a Morphe brush. And it was a bronzer brush. And I freaking hate it. It sheds everywhere, so I said we're not doing that anymore. And see, I like this. If I don't want to get precise with my bronzer, my nose contour brush, I just literally use this. I pinch this and I do this. And then I do this. And I do this. This is what I do for work. And see, the nose looked like I put some time into it, and I really did. And again, I got this birthday machine. And our last newest object that we bought is the Rare Beauty, the soft pinched luminous powder blush. And I got the shade Truth. This is what it looks like. And let me show you what the blush looks like. It's really pretty. Okay, so I really still haven't found the best brush to use for this. I don't know if I want to use something like this. Because I feel like a fluffy brush doesn't do good with that. Maybe let's do this, angle brush. Okay. And I like it because... And see, I don't know if y'all can see what it does to the brush. So that's what I'm like, maybe...
That was too much.
Talking to y'all. Jeez Louise. I like it because it makes your face look kind of glowy. Like I really want to try Hourglass. Hourglass, that new palette. That bronze and blush palette. Because I like the way it makes their face look so highlighted. And it makes your face look kind of like shiny. Like it's like a wet but mattifying face. But I can't spend $90 on something that I don't think that's going to show. You know? It's really made for lighter complexion girls. So I don't know, but I want him right here on this blush. And I don't know if y'all can see it. But you see the glow? I know you see the glow. Okay. So that was the reason why I got it. I really wanted a blush that kind of like gives you like that glow. You really don't need a highlighter. Makes your face look nice and shiny, but mattifying at the same time. And I feel like that's what this highlighter does. Or this blush slash highlighter does. Okay, so I'm just pushing it all in. Okay, so now I'm going to take the Makeup by Mario again. The loosening powder. My memory. I have 4 minutes left of my memory. My goodness. And then we're just going to go underneath. Okay, now it's time to get rid of this bake. I don't like bake staying on for a long time. I'm going to use my one size in shade dark one. Pat it inside here. And get rid of this line. And we're just going to kind of put it over everything to make everything blend in. Y'all see what it did to the forehead? The nose. Okay, so the baby half lashes are on. I think they look really good. Okay, so I really don't have really bake underneath my eyes, but I'm just going to push in whatever that Makeup by Mario we had left underneath my eyes. But you see how it looks flawless. You saw how crazy it looked in the beginning, but when I continue to like push it in, it dissolves into my skin. Okay, and add a little bit of Charlotte Tilbury shade number 2 in the underneath my eyes, just to kind of brighten it up just a little bit. Is it needed? Absolutely not. But this is what the shade looks like. I'm just pat it, and we are just gonna do this. Just kind of leave it here. Then you can bring it out if you want. Same thing to the other side. Pat it. Gonna use this palette, and there's a brighter silver shade here. I'm gonna just put that in the inner corner. My allergies is acting up now. Nah, I need to freaking take some Zyrtec, baby. I don't know if y'all can even notice a difference. I can, but I don't know if y'all can. I don't know, but too much. That's it. Let's set the face before I put some mascara at the bottom. We are going to use our Morphe setting spray. And this just pushes everything. Not pushes. It makes the powders all mesh well. I'm gonna let this dry. And then I'm going to use the Charlotte Tilbury setting spray. I should use the Morphe. This one. But that's a hit and miss. Sometimes it works too well where my eyes just start to water because it's so freaking strong. I don't have time really to fix my makeup because I got to go cook dinner. So I think we're just going to go to what I know is going to work good without burning my face. Charlotte Tilbury setting spray. Okay, so I think I'm going to go with like a red lip or off burnish brick red lip. So this is the Morphe lip liner in shade called Wine Me. And I'm just going to line. Okay, and I think I'm going to put a brown on top of that. Just to kind of make it a little bit darker. Trendsetter, Morphe. Just to darken it a little bit. But you still see that hint of that red a little bit. Okay. Then I'm gonna go on with my MAC, and then this is in Devoted to Chili. Okay. I got to, had to keep deleting some videos to get some memory, but a little bit more. And I'm going to take Trendsetter. Kind of go over it a little bit. I do got to do a little highlight on my nose. So I always use my MAC highlighter. And I use this, it's like a gold shade. And I'm going to just put a little bit, I'm going to just use my finger actually. A little bit on the nose, a little bit here. Maybe just a little bit here. Just to shine it up a little bit. Okay, so this is the final look. I hope you guys like it. I'm gonna try to maybe get some type of footage of me with my whole entire outfit on at the concert. So we'll see. But this is the look that I'm giving for the concert. I think it looks really pretty. And I love the new stuff that I just bought. Like that makeup by Mario, 10 out of 10. Rare Beauty, I say 9 out of 10. I just have to figure out what brush I have to that works best with that. I think it's going to be a beauty blender. Just pushing it down in that blush and just kind of like working its way in the skin. But it's very pretty. It's very pigmented too. So I love that one as well. And then what's my other new product? Let me ponder. That is a really a shame. Like that tells you I don't need any more products. The one size oil sucker. Again, I'm going to show you how I feel about that after this concert. Maybe I'll do like a wear test. I don't know. I'll be making false promises that I can't uphold. But anyways, that one seems pretty okay. I wore twice for work. And that did really well. Is it worth $36? I don't know. I got to still play with that one. But I love the makeup by Mario. I mean, that one was definitely worth my, I think it's $36. I love the color. But this is the final look. I hope you guys liked it. Don't forget to like, comment, and subscribe to the channel and tell me what you guys think about this look. Let me know what else you guys want to see or what other products you want me to use. Thanks. Bye. Okay, y'all. So it's been about 3 hours. I'm about to go to the concert now. I did not retouch my face and I was in the oven cooking. I was in front of grease cooking homemade mozzarella sticks and my face still looks my face still looks good. Okay. The only thing I had to retouch was my lips because, yeah, I ate that all off. But this is the final look 3 hours later. Hopefully, I can record at the concert, but we'll see. But or I'm going to record when I come back to show you the one size. That's the point of me doing it, the wear test. And it's not greasy. It's not oily. So we'll see how it looks after the concert. Okay, so the time is now midnight. I just got home from the concert. I have to be quiet. I already lost my voice. But this is the face. I mean, my face is not oily. I mean, it is slightly. But, I mean, I think it's more of the light that's making it look more shinier than anything. My makeup didn't separate or anything. But I did lose my damn voice. But it looks good. So I would definitely say the one size is good. And then you see the Mario setting powder. I didn't crease at all. And I think I've had this on. So what time did I say? I started around 3:30. And it's midnight. So I will definitely recommend these two items that I bought. But yeah, my voice is gone and it's midnight. But I just wanted to come back on with my little wear test. Yeah. But yeah, this is the final look after I think 8 hours. 6 hours. I don't know. I'm tired, but I'll put it on the screen somewhere below. But thanks for watching, guys. Bye.